A rectangle is inscribed with its base on the x-axis and its upper corners on the parabola y equals 25 minus x squared. What are the dimensions of such a rectangle with the greatest possible area? To solve this problem, it'll help by starting to sketch that parabola. So there's a graph of 25 minus x squared, and then we want a rectangle inside of it with the base on the x-axis and the upper corners touching the parabola, something like this. Now, there are several possible rectangles that would work here. So let's look at a couple of them. So we could have one that's really wide but not very tall, like this one, where you'll notice the upper right corner is touching the graph at 4.9. And because the parabola is symmetric, the rectangle will be symmetric too. So the other point is at negative 4.9. So you'll notice that the area, the width of the rectangle along the base there is 8 because it's going from negative 4 to 4. The height is 9, the area ends up being 72. Now another rectangle could be this one, which is much narrower and taller. This one ends up having a width of 2, a height of 24, an area of 48. So you'll notice it's a different area, in this case smaller. And then here's one more rectangle. This one has a width of 6 and a height of 16 for an area of 96, which is even bigger than the first one. And so we're wondering, okay, what rectangle would have the biggest of all those possible areas? So let's imagine sort of an arbitrary rectangle where the coordinates where the rectangle touches the curve are at some x, y, right? But we know something about y because this point lies on the parabola, so that y is really 25 minus x squared. So let's see if we can figure out the dimensions of this rectangle. So we know that that distance is x because that's where the x coordinate is. And because of the symmetry then, the whole width of the rectangle is going to be 2x. Likewise, the height of the rectangle is given by the y coordinate of that upper right corner of the rectangle where it touches the curve. So the height of the rectangle is given by the y value, which in this case is 25 minus x squared. So we can put those together now. So the area of this rectangle would be width times height. The width is 2x and the height is 25 minus x squared. And we could simplify that a little bit by distributing the 2x to get 50x minus 2x cubed. Now to find the x value that will make that area as big as possible, because that's a cubic, we can't just use like a vertex formula. So we're going to turn to technology here. So I'm going to pull up a grapher and type in that equation. And you see this graph here, which those lines seem to be going off the graph pretty far. And so I'm going to need to adjust the window here. And you can use things like table and things like that to help you figure out a reasonable values, or you can just guess. And depending upon your function, you might also need to adjust the x min and x max. But here I adjusted the y min and y max and got a much better looking graph. And then in this grapher, I could just click on that top point and it told me the coordinates of that point where, as you can see, the area is the largest. And so that tells me then that the area will be largest when x is about 2.887. So now let's go back to our rectangle, right? We said that the area was this 50x minus 2x cubed. We just figured out that the area will be largest when x is about 2.887. And so then relating that back to our formula, right, at that x value, the width would be 2x. So 2 times the 2.887 is about 5.774. And the height of the rectangle was given by the y value of the function. So that's 25 minus x squared. Again, plug in that x value and we can get about 16.665. And there we go. Those are the dimensions of the rectangle, the width and the height of the rectangle with the largest possible area. And it turns out in this case, that area is about 96.224.